Welcome back, everyone. My name is Joel Feld, and today's topic is discussing the concept of sharing photographs and specifically doing shared albums with iCloud photos. Here we go. There's many different ways to share photos and videos with family, friends, whomever it may be. You can upload to social media, go to Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, you name it. There's a bajillion places, Google Drive, Google Photos. If you're using the storage of iCloud and you're using iCloud Photos, if you haven't started using photo streams or shared photo albums, you're missing out because there's a lot of potential with these. You have the ability to create them from your iPhone, your iPad, your Mac. So let's go ahead and get started. We'll create one. We'll show you the options that you have to share it and how it shows up on all of your devices. So let's start with opening up Photos on the computer. And first, you just really need to figure out, well, what do you want to share? And for me, let's go ahead and use the example. My fiance and I actually were up the North Shore recently this past weekend, and I have some photographs here, and I have all these different photographs. Some of them are of food, and some of them are the lighthouse. I had my drone out there. It was ridiculously cold, but well worth it for some of the photos that we got. Here's the lighthouse. If you haven't been up the North Shore, Lake Superior, it's a good time. It's very, very scenic. You know, we got some cliffs at Palisade. I don't know how to say it, but some really gorgeous views. So I want to take all of these pictures here from that weekend, and I want to put it into a shared album so I can share it with my fiance, my mom, brother, sister, whomever it may be. So let's start off by selecting the photos that I want to include. So I'm going to select the first one here. I'm going to scroll down, and a lot of these pictures are either with my cell phone or with my DSLR camera. So we'll keep going down. There's Grand Marais and down to here. Okay, so now that I've selected these photographs, in the top right-hand side of Photos, I have the share button. And I can click on the box with a little upwards arrow and do shared album. Or I can go up to the file menu, go to share and do shared albums as well. Or I could come to the left-hand side and under shared albums, I can click the plus sign and also create a shared album this way. There's no right or wrong way to do it. I usually select the photos first and then I click the button up here to do shared albums. Now, actually, let me take a step back. Let's only select some of these photos because then I'll show you how to add more photos to it afterwards. So I'm gonna select these pictures and we will go to up until the point of this cool dude out on the beach. So we'll do the last food here. So I'm gonna click on the share button, do shared albums. And this is where it's pretty much asking, do I wanna add to an existing shared library or an existing shared album, or do I wanna create a new shared album? So I'm gonna do new shared album. We're gonna call it North Shore Winter. No, this was North Shore Lutzen. We'll do North Shore Lutzen Winter 2021. Now the invite people, this is where I would choose to invite people. So I'm actually going to do learn with Joel at iCloud.com. And I can always add more people to the subscribed, or I don't even have to add anyone and I can still share this link with people. The beautiful thing about sharing this is you do not need an Apple product or iCloud to view it. You could send this shared album to someone that is using an Android phone or just a computer, or they don't even have to have an account because it can be a public link. So actually, let's delete myself out of here. I'm just going to remove the subscriber because you're subscribing to it, and I'm not gonna do anything and we'll add it afterwards. I don't need any comments with the photo, so I'm just gonna choose create. Now, when I click create there, notice over here on the left-hand side, it created this North Shore Lutzen Winter 2021 album for me, and the photos that I selected are gonna slowly go into this album. And notice at the top here, I have a little progress bar that it's saying, hey, it's sharing 105 items to this North Shore, and those pictures will slowly show up there. Now, one thing I hope Apple improves is the ability just to create a simple folder in shared albums. I use them a lot and it's just a long list. There's no way to organize them. And it kind of is a little frustrating, but hopefully they have that ability to actually organize them. So we can start to see them populate in photos here, but I only did that first 100 or so photos. So let's say I want to add more photos. So I'm going to go back to the library. So I can select more here and we'll go down to this video here. And I can also take them and drag them to the North Shore shared album on the left-hand side. And that will add them as well. Notice the little progress bar up here at the top. So it's adding those 32 items. And then another way to add them is directly going from the shared album. I can go up to the top here where it says add photos and videos. And it's going to go through the pictures, show me the my whole entire library, and I can add them this way as well. This is not necessarily my preferred method of viewing it this way because it kind of mixes them all up, but let's just say I wanted to add this picture, and this picture. In the top right, I can click add, and that will add those pictures into the shared album here. Now that's going to take a moment for it to catch up. It always takes a little bit of time. So if I jump to my iPad, I can go to the top left to open up the sidebar, go to my photos. I can untoggle the shared albums. And here it is right here at the top, North Shore Lutes in Winter 2021. When I select that, I'll see all of the photographs that I've added from the computer. Now, if I wanted to add photos from my phone, I could do that, or my iPad as well. Same process on the iPhone or iPad, identical way to create, add, and subscribe. In the top right, I can click the three little dots, and this gives me the option to either share these photos, add more photos, invite people. The zooming in, zooming out, honestly, is the same thing as pinching your fingers inwards and outwards. Aspect ratio just changes the photos so that they're either showing the aspect ratio of how that photo is cropped, or if you go back to square, it'll just show everything as a square. I can rename the album, I can filter all the photos, all the videos, and all of this you can do on the computer as well as your iPhone. But the three little dots in here allow you to see and kind of filter, and you know, I can show them all on a map, see exactly where these pictures were at, which is really, really helpful. So if I wanted to add more pictures, I could go back to library. I could select, let's say this here. I could go to the share button in the top right, and I could scroll down and say add to shared album. If I touch that, it's going to give me an option to make a comment on this photo. And underneath that, I have the option to say shared album. And if I touch that, it's pretty much saying what album is this photograph going into. So I don't want it to go in Winter Swans. I don't want it to go into something else. So I'm going to go back North Shore Lutes in Winter 2021 and touch post at the top right. And now this photograph is being added to that shared album. Now let's go back to the computer here. I can go back to the library, and this is where I can add the remaining photographs. So we'll select from here. Oh, this guy was, okay. Picture perfect moment. This one guy had this like stick. He had like this homemade filter, this sifter that he was making to like scoop up the rocks and like sort through them. And I was like, oh, this is like out of a storybook. And so here's this guy that totally looks the part. And he's just, it's, keep in mind, it's like 20 below, and he's just out there like no big deal. It was crazy. So I had to, of course, take pictures of him, because why not? Okay, so here we go. Let's scroll down, and we're gonna add the rest of these photographs. And I already added that one, so I'm gonna deselect that one, and I can just drag that into the North Shore, and that's going to add the remaining photographs there. So now that I have the shared album, I can now start to invite people to it, as well as control who can add photos, or if I want to create a public link for this, meaning that I can share it with anyone who doesn't have an Apple product. So if I have this album selected here on the left, in the top right, I can click on the little icon of this person, and this shows me exactly who to share it with, and if I want to do permissions for like a public website, for example. So if I do public website, if I click on this, this allows anyone to view this shared album on iCloud.com. So it actually gives me this link here. And if I click on this, it's going to pull up a web browser and I can view all of the photographs from any web browser. This doesn't require you to have an Apple computer. It doesn't require you to have an iPhone, an iPad, a Mac, iCloud subscription. This is literally the ability to share these photos, this kind of private photo gallery, with anyone and everyone that that you want to send this link to. So you can click on here, you can download them, you can go full screen, it'll play a slideshow for you. It's really a nice way to share photographs with family and friends. So very, very cool. Let's minimize that and go back. Now, this is where you want to start inviting people. Let's do the learn with Joel at iCloud.com, press return. And what's going to happen is, now notice on my iPad here, I got a little notification at the top. It said, hey, Joel Feld invited you to North Shore Lutzen. And that actually shows up if I go to the Photos app, I can find it under the For You category. That's where they typically put it. So here I can see, hey, Joel Feld invited you. Do you want to either accept it or decline it? So I will touch accept. And now I'm going to be able to see all of the pictures that I post with this account. And the more people that I invite to this shared album, they're able to post as well. So notice if I go back to my computer here and click on the little silhouette of the person, I have this option that says subscribers can post. So that means that because I just subscribed with the Learn with Joel account, I can actually go on the iPad here, go under shared albums here, and in the top right, I have the ability to touch the little circles and then do add photos, or if I scroll all the way down to the bottom, I can touch the plus sign and add photos that way. And that gives me the ability, if you're on a vacation or a road trip, everyone can kind of collectively share their photos, which is really nice, because how many times are all of you taking pictures at the same time, and then you're like, well, what did they take over there? What pictures and videos did they take? This gives you a solid way to actually share photographs in a family gathering or get together with friends, whatever it may be. Next on here is notifications. This, just having that turned on, allows you to get the notifications like we just saw on the iPad, or if someone comments on a photograph, you'll get those notifications saying someone liked this photo, or you know, they made a comment on that. And those show up in the activity of shared albums. So over here on the left-hand side, I see activity. And also notice on my computer in the top right, it said so-and-so joined this album. So we can see that. But here under the activity, this shows me the date and it shows who shared the photographs. And I can just scroll through and kind of see an ongoing list of all of the shared videos or photos that have been shared. And as I scroll down even farther, you know, I have lots of different shared albums. Here's, you know, my mom commented on the swans here. So here she liked this and she made a comment of three hearts. So it's almost like creating your own personal private little online gallery that you can share with your friends and family. It's really, really cool. Might as well add Lisa to this because, you know, she was there. And if I type in Lisa, it'll either identify people by their telephone number or their email address that's linked with their Apple ID. Just then, it's going to send her a message on her device, and I'll be able to see when she accepts it and all of that. Also notice that by each one, there is next to Joel, which is my Learn with Joel account, I have a little check mark to show that that person is subscribed. And next to Lisa, it shows a little question mark saying this person has not responded yet. And vice versa on the iPads here. If I go back to North Shore here, if I touch the little silhouette of the person, I can see that people are invited and I can see that who has said yes to it also. And again, it's the same exact information for subscribers can post, public website, notifications, same exact thing. Lisa just subscribed there, so now we can see her notification and now I'm able to see, I get that notification because I have it turned on. And also, what's really nice is all of the photos and videos that you put in here do not count against your iCloud storage, which is awesome. So you could put 1,000 photos and videos in here, and they're actually not accommodating your iCloud storage that you may or may not pay for. Now, there are some limitations to that, and because the pictures are in a shared album, it does not mean that they're in your own library. They're not physically downloaded to your device. They're out there in the cloud. They're not actually taking up space on your phone or your iPad unless you actually touch each one and download it. So that really gives you an opportunity to kind of leverage the shared photo albums in different ways that you may not have thought about. I'll pull up a help article here off of Apple's website. If I go here, they actually have instructions on how to create shared albums and all of that kind of stuff. But if I go all the way down to the bottom, they have this shared album storage limits. So you can actually put up to 5,000 photos and videos into a shared photo album, which is really nice. And it even says your photos and videos and shared albums are kept in iCloud, but they don't count against your storage limit. And also they have another help article that I'll link in the description below of the limitations, because there are some limitations. 1,000 photos per hour. So if you're trying to use it for non-personal uses, you might get flagged where it stops working and then it pauses temporarily and then it'll start up tomorrow or the following day. But you can kind of read through this. There are some things that I wish and I hope that they change. For example, maximum shared albums by an owner can be 200. I hope that they make that unlimited or 500 or 1,000. I don't know how many shared albums I have right now, but my concern is 5 years from now, I will probably meet that 200 threshold and not sure what I'm gonna do when that happens. I'm gonna have to consolidate my shared albums. But go ahead and look through this. This will give you the nitty-gritty information about the shared albums. Regardless, it's really, really nice to be able to share pictures in a kind of a more private gallery type way that doesn't take up iCloud storage, and it's really, really easy to do. And again, if I wanted to create another new shared album on here, I could go on my iPad, I could unfold shared albums, scroll down towards the bottom, I can choose new shared album, and again it gives me the same exact thing to create the name of it. So let's just say, I'm just gonna say drone pictures and do next. And then it's saying, who is it going to? Well, maybe I'm not sure who I'm gonna send this to. So you don't always have to put someone in here. You can always add them later. So I'm gonna do create, and I can touch the plus sign here. And now I can just go through and add all of the drone pictures wherever I find them. All right, so here's a drone picture, here, 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 here. So I can go through and pretty much make a brand new and touch done in the top right. So now it's creating a brand new shared album that's all drone pictures, and I can share this with whomever I want. Ah, one last thing. If you don't have shared albums here, you need to go to the preferences for photos, and you have to make sure that you have shared albums selected here. If this isn't selected or checked underneath iCloud, you're not gonna have all of these options. So photos, preferences, go to iCloud, and then make sure you have shared albums selected. And same thing with on your iPad or your iPhone, go into the settings, go to your iCloud, go to photos, and turn on shared albums down here at the bottom. So that way you know that the shared albums are available, they're turned on for you to use whenever you want. So that is iCloud shared photo albums in a nutshell. I hope you enjoyed watching. I hope you learned something. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked what you saw, hit that little subscribe button, tap that little bell, and we'll see you next time.